Hey guys, Johnny Crimson 2000 here, and welcome back to Let's Play Dead or Alive Xtreme Beach Volleyball. This is part 6. Alright, so let's go ahead and get this thing started. As you guys see here, this is what I was talking about in the last part. All the way on the left there, we see Kasumi Day 7 Morning, 1606. That's in hours, folks. That's how much time I've spent on this game. This one's my friend, so it doesn't really matter. And this is ours, so let's go ahead and start here. And I actually wanted to take a look at something. Look at that. As you guys see here, there's an option here which says your age. And you may be wondering what that means. Actually, let me see some language settings. Okay, Zach's voice in English. Alright, that's pretty cool. So, for those of you who've never played a Dead or Alive game before, your age, you may be wondering what the point of this is. Essentially what it is, I have it at 25 because, hey, I'm 25 years old. That's my age. But we're actually going to bump this up. You're going to be thanking me for this. At least I think you will, if this does what I think it is, what it's supposed to do. And essentially what it does is, it's a pretty sneaky way that Team Ninja has incorporated an option of how much booby bounce you want in your game. That's essentially what it is. But before we start our day here, before we see the fruits of our labor, so to speak, we're going to change our outfit to the chameleon, which is the one that we got from Hitomi, I think 2 days ago. And we're actually going to change our hairstyle. Quite tie. Actually, you know what? Let's go long hair. We haven't done long hair in a while. Yes, I am very picky as far as how my girls look here. So, we're going to go back to this right here, and we're going to try to see if we can find any other items that Christy hopefully likes. As I said, guys, my goal here, at least right now, is I want Christy to be able to give us one of her outfits. That's my goal for right now. And I'm trying to find any items here that... I'm looking, for those of you who don't know, I'm looking at the guide here. That's why I'm taking breaks every now and then. Like, I look at these things, and every now and then I'll look back just to see if I... Okay, here it is, the guitar. Guitar, and then we're going to wrap that up. And then we're going to actually, we're going to buy her an outfit as well. Ooh, we're getting fancy here because we actually get to see her right there. So I'm going to go to the sports shop. And then we're going to see if we can buy an outfit. And you know what? We're probably going to buy ourselves an outfit too. Just because we're high spenders here. I'm just taking a look at all the things that they have here. I'll probably buy this one. But let's see what kind of... It says here that she likes Iris. I think Iris is... No, it's not on here. Damn. Last time we got her a tulip. So we can't get her the same one over again. I mean, we could... But I want her to get some different. And I... Amaryllis? Amaryllis? Is that something? Like I said, guys, like, all you can really do here... Yeah, here it is. Amaryllis. So let's get her that. Alright, and then let's get something for us, just because. Let's get this one. Why not? We need something yellow. Alright, and then... You know, because we have so much freaking money. And I think that's... Yeah, I think that'll do it for right now. No, I don't want that. Let's get something for Hitomi while we're here. Let's get the daily. Goodbye, and then we're going to wrap it, and then we're going to give it to her tomorrow. All right, so we got everything set. So let's go ahead and play against these girls here to start the day. So yeah, like I said, I actually didn't know that there was actually this option here in this game, but apparently, yeah, it does. It's a Dead or Alive series staple, I guess. It's a custom, I don't know what you call it, that you have the option to change the age of, you know, of yourself. And like I said, that's a very sneaky way that Team Ninja has put in as an option to how much booby bounce you want on your girls. I'm actually curious to see how this affects it, because I never once, as you guys saw, I never once actually changed it from 25 years old. I just assumed that it doesn't seem to affect it all that much, honestly, from what I can see. But I've always just kept it at 25 because, you know... Oh, come on. Like I said, most of the time in this game in particular, maybe not so much in the fighting games because you actually get more zoomed in, you know, you can actually look at the girls. But in this game in particular, I never really paid much attention to that sort of stuff, you know? Mostly because I'm just paying attention to the ball. Like, I'm not looking at the girls all that much. Ooh, right in the stomach. See, like right here, I'm not really noticing all that much bounce, to be honest. And to be honest, I've never really noticed all that much bounce. Like, I played around with all the Dead or Alive games that I've had. Like, they all have that. They all have the option of changing your age. And I've known about that trick ever since, you know, ever since I first saw it, you know. It was kind of something nice. Even though I jumped over there for no reason. Well, see, even there, like, there's a little bit of bounce, but nowhere near as exaggerated as I thought it was going to be. Like I said, if you really want some, like, exaggerated bounce, play Dead or Alive Xtreme 2. That has redonkulous bounce. Like seriously, redonkulous bounce. It's just bad. It's almost comical in a way, because you actually get to see... I think I've mentioned it before, where I'm pretty sure Team Ninja developed an entirely new, like, gravity engine or something specifically for the boobs in Dead or Alive Xtreme 2, to the point where they're just lounging around and they'll move all of, like, 2 inches to the left. They'll shift their body 2 inches to the left, and then all of a sudden you see just massive amounts of fan service boobs going all over the place, and even to the extent that one boob is going, like, bouncing up one way and then the other boob is going off to the other, and it's just ridiculous. Just look up any kind of videos containing that and you'll see what I mean. It's pretty damn silly, if I do say so myself. Alright, let's play against these girls. See, like, I'm split though, because on the one hand I could use this time to give Christy one of the items, and then but then I don't want to. Alright, let's... Yeah, I can't take that risk, so I'm gonna give the present to Christy right now. So, sorry, we have Amaryllis. Daisy's the one for Katomi. So I'm gonna give her the guitar right now. Yes. The good thing, though, is that we now get to see her wearing... Or not. I thought we were going to see her wearing the outfit, but I don't think I've actually given her an outfit yet. And there you go. I think we've actually gotten a guitar as a present from Zach, or one of the girls. I can't remember who. And like I said, there's really no point to them whatsoever. The only point is to really just butter up the girls. But if you yourself have it, there's not much point to having the item. Unfortunately, it would have been cool to see, I don't know, like, if items to put on your girl, but I guess it would get in the way of the volleyball, so I guess that doesn't make much sense either. Alright, so this is the last volleyball game of the day. We're moving along here rather quickly, now that we have the ball rolling, so to speak. Aha! Puns. Alright, and booyah! How many times have we faced Leifang, exactly? I feel like I face her every time I play this game for this damn Let's Play. I've seen that orange outfit so many damn times. It's so... Oh god, get up. Reminds me of Nickelodeon. Here we go. By the way, I know this is sort of really out there for me to say this. It has nothing to do with the game, but I've actually, speaking of Nickelodeon, which is the only reason why I'm gonna say this, is I actually went on this wiki, which is a very interesting wiki. Booyah! Good god, right in Helena's face. Jesus, let's take a look at that. Wait for it. And booyah! In your face, girl. I went on this really interesting wiki. I found this wiki about maybe a year or so ago. It's a very nice one. It's a very cool one. It's called the Lost Media Wiki. And the whole point of this wiki is that there's a bunch of articles listing items in, like, media. So things like music, film, television, video games even, that have been lost. So that means that either they were present at some point and then for whatever reason they've just been lost. Like, there's no trace of them, there's no way to get them. And it's a very cool wiki. It's a very, very nice wiki. I check back on it maybe once every couple days just to see, you know, oh, come on. I'm not ashamed to say that I've probably read every single article in that wiki. Mind you, I started about a year ago when there was only about 100. So it was manageable back then. Nowadays, I think it has like 300. It's grown a considerable amount, and it gets updated a fair amount of times by a fair amount of people. So I think nowadays it has like 300 or so. So it's been easier for me to keep up with it. But anyways, speaking of Nickelodeon, there was one article that said on there it's a very, very strange piece of media that's been lost relating to the Rugrats. If you guys don't remember, if you're a 90s baby like I was, you know who the Rugrats are. You know the show The Rugrats. That's probably one of the most popular shows on Nickelodeon. It was only ever, I think, in my opinion, it was only ever sort of beaten when SpongeBob came along. So SpongeBob is the only other cartoon from Nickelodeon that ever was really any more popular than the Rugrats. So anyway, this specific article mentioned about how there was apparently a time when the directors or the people working behind, you know, the Rugrats, so like the director, the writer, the animator, whatever, they were in this table and they passed around a storyboard paper, which if you guys don't know, it's basically just a piece of paper that has some squares on it, and basically all you do is you draw some doodles detailing what, you know, what an episode will look like or what a scene in the episode will look like. And apparently this piece of paper, they were all around in this table, and I guess they just had a writer's block or something. They just couldn't come up with a new episode, and what the hell just happened there? And essentially what they were doing, good God, Hitomi, stop throwing yourself, or Kazumi, rather. And they were passing around this piece of paper, and the point was that, you know, it was a, I can't remember what it's called, but it's one of those things where, you know, you draw something, you draw in, like, three little squares, and then you pass it on to the next person, they draw in three little squares, you know, stuff like that, where eventually they would have an entire storyboard, where multiple people had contributed to the storyboard. So anyway, and this was like an episode of the Rugrats. And, you know, things started off, it was pretty uneventful. They were basically just doing this just to blow off some steam, you know, they writer's block, long day, what have you. And apparently, according to this article, this wiki, oh look, we got something for Christy, finally. And let's go and make the gift first. Let's see. Amaryllis, that one's going to, and then, oh no, oh damn, I gave it to the wrong person, all right, whatever, let's see if that works. I was supposed to, oh, damn it, this is what happens when I'm talking about Rugrats. So anyway, let's view the items here before I continue with my Rugrats spiel, because you guys are actually going to be pretty impressed with what I have to say, or not impressed, but you guys are going to be pretty interested with what I have to say, believe me, if you're a fan of Rugrats, you will. And we got something from Hitomi there, and just by the look of the gift box or whatever, I can already tell, prediction here, I can already tell this is going to be an outfit, which is pretty cool. Let's see if I'm right. Open, and booyah, we got a Hydra, which is pretty awesome. Awesome. All right, let's see. Christy probably didn't give us an outfit, which makes me a very, very sad panda, because all I want to do is get something from Christy, an outfit from Christy, but let's see what she gave us. And it comes a submachine gun. Awesome. Let's see if we can shoot. And it's not loaded. Thank God. All right. So let's just keep that. And let's see. We have the chameleon on. But I'm pretty sure. Didn't I buy something? Didn't I? Oh yeah. We got this. We pansy. All right. So strange name for an outfit. Alright, so let's go. We are going on to day 10, I believe. Holy crap, we're almost done with this playthrough, guys. Jesus. Or actually, no, day 11. Holy crap. So anyway, as I was saying here, they had an entire storyboard lined up. All the guys had drawn something. But apparently the nature of it was really, really raunchy. So it started off I think Angelica was doing something bad to Tommy, and he got pissed off or something, and then he went into the kitchen or something, and he got some sort of chemical or something, and he put it inside of a bottle or some juice. He essentially tried to kill Angelica. That's basically what it amounted to. Man, I don't think there's anything here for... Oh, wait. Scholarly book Cyborg. That's something that she likes, but it's really expensive, and... I don't know if I want that. I'm a very sad panda right now. And, you know, we're gonna skip out on getting her something from here, unfortunately. There's really nothing here for Christy. I don't think. Yeah, I don't think there's anything there. Alright, let's go to the sports shop. And, so Tommy went in there. He came back. He wanted to get Angelica to drink this potion of deathness. And, Dee Dee came in there. Dee Dee being, if you guys don't remember, Dee Dee is Tommy's mom. And she came in there. She tried to take the bottle away or the juice away. And then all of a sudden, Stu came in there from the side. Stu is, do I have this? No, I don't. Okay, let's get this one, then. Let's get that one for ourselves. And then no, since we're balling here, we have so much money. And then Stu came in there, and then he just kicked Dee Dee out of the way, and all of a sudden, I can't remember what it is, but it was just very, like, from then on, he forces Tommy to drink the juice, which has, like, poison or something in it. And then it shows in the storyboard, Tommy starts convulsing. He starts having seizures. And you can see it in the storyboard. It's very, very bad. And all of a sudden, he looks on Angelica and starts making very, very provocative stuff. Like, you're going to call me daddy soon, or you're going to be daddy's girl. And so it's basically assumed that, ooh, nice, right in the face. It's basically assumed there's only one page left, so you can actually go online and actually see the scan of this storyboard that they did. And it's only one page. Apparently there were multiple pages, but apparently from what the wiki article said, the people that worked on this or contributed to this storyboard claim that there was very perverse claims of incest, and then there's like scenes of Angelica performing sexual acts with freaking Stu, which is all kinds of wrong when you think about it. I mean, for starters, it's Angelica. She's like what, four? Not even five. And then with Stu, who is her uncle, like how awful is that? So long story short, there's this very sick storyboard. There's a very sick, very wrong storyboard page that apparently was done sometime in the 90s, in the late 90s, I think. Done by the actual people who did Rugrats, so it's not just, some fan that did this and made it very perverse. No, this was actually done by actual Rugrats staff, animators and writers and stuff like that. I heard that eventually that, some of the pages were locked away, or maybe they were even thrown in the trash. So it's not very likely that we'll ever see the whole thing. But it's just one of those interesting things, It's like, it's a very sick, but I don't know. I have there's a matter of intrigue somewhere in there of, I just want to be able to see, how bad this thing got. Even though, yes, it is a very, very bad content. But the fact that actual Nickelodeon people, and I know, they work in kids programming, but they're still, they're still normal people. It's not like, that's like saying like all Disney employees are angels. Like, no, like they're regular people, but still, it's, I don't know. How the hell did I get to talking about this? Oh yeah, that's right. Lei Fang had that bright ass outfit that reminded me of the Nickelodeon logo. I don't even know if they still have that logo. Do they still have the orange, the bright ass orange splatter logo? I don't know, man. I'm just over here owning here. Hoo-yah! Nice! See, that's what happens when I do these live Let's Plays here. It's like, after a while, I'm just like, I get sidetracked. Alright, here we go. Match point, baby. Man, I can't believe this is day 11. There's only 3 days left. Jesus. Oh, God! By the way, I don't know if I mentioned this or not. I think I have previously. But the most expensive outfit in this game is called the Venus. The Venus is the most expensive outfit, but it's for a good reason, and it's possibly the hardest outfit to get in the entire game. Essentially what it is it's I don't know how to describe it. It's basically just thong. It's not even a thong. It's just freaking it's string that just so happens to cover certain parts of the woman's body. And it's as you can probably tell, it's the most scantily clad outfit in the entire game, and the only person that has access to it is our dear friend Lisa, who was actually the first person that we partnered up with. So the only way that you can actually get it is do I have something here? Oh yeah, that's right. I'm gonna change my outfits here. I'm gonna change it to Hydra. No, not Hydra. This is the new one, right? Yeah. Let's wear that one. And so the only way to get it is to butter up Lisa. Actually, no, you have to play as Lisa, because the only way that you can get it is to buy it yourself at your own shop as Lisa, and then you have to trade it to other girls. Now, the problem is that the Venus swimsuit, if you even call it a swimsuit, is quite possibly one of the most hated outfits by the girls. I don't think there's a single girl in this entire game that actually likes the item. So, as I mentioned before, there's different classes of items. Like, there's some items that girls really love, so they'll accept it all the time. There's some outfits that they only like, so, you know, depending on how they feel towards you, they may accept it, they may not. And then there's items that they dislike, and then there's items that they hate. The Venus is one of those items that pretty much every girl hates. So it's extremely difficult to get one of the girls to accept it. So if you, it takes a lot of patience. It takes a lot of sort of buttering up of a girl. There's certain, I've read somewhere that there's certain tricks that you can do in order to guarantee that they accept items that girls don't typically like girls that, or items that normally they would not accept, including the Venus. But the problem with the Venus is that not only is it one of the most despised outfits, or possibly the most despised outfit of any of the swimsuits in this game, but it's also the most expensive. The Venus is the only item in this game that costs $1 million. So, as you guys see, right now I have $700,000. That's not even, or I think I have about $700,000. That's not even enough to buy one single Venus swimsuit. So not only do you have to play a crap ton, but you also have to make sure and make damn sure that the girl that you're trying to give it to accepts the item, accepts the Venus outfit. Because if they don't, then you just wasted $1 million, a million Zach dollars. So it, aw, damn it, I was trying to go for a perfect. So the Venus outfit is probably the hardest item to get in this game. It's the hardest item to get girls to accept. Because it's not like, you know, for some items you can possibly get them to accept it after a couple tries, but, you know, it's one of those things where it's like, you don't, it's not like you have $1 million to spare every time you want to try. So it's a very difficult, I've even in my main file, I've never bought the Venus outfit. I don't know if I even want to, honestly. It's just an outfit. I mean, this game is before achievements. If this game had an achievement, like, you know, achievement unlocked, you got somebody, one of the girls, to accept the Venus outfit. Good God, that was close. Booyah, get off me, Christy. Still love you, though. Give me an outfit, damn it. And hooah! Oh, damn it. If there were achievements, then maybe I'd put in more time and effort to try to get one of these girls to accept the Venus outfit, but simply put, it's one of those things where it's really just a bragging right, really. And yeah, it's nice to see the girls half naked, but really, these are virtual girls. What's wrong with you? No, it's fun though. Maybe one day I'll try to get one of these girls to accept the Venus outfit, but I have to spend enough time to actually get enough money to buy the outfit in the first place. I don't know if I have that kind of time, honestly. Like $1 million, really. Like, you guys will see. I mean, I've been pretty lenient as far as the stuff that I've been buying so far in this playthrough, and I have. We'll check right now after this game how much money I have, just to kind of put it into perspective how long it takes to save up $1 million in this game. I mean, if you're really good at volleyball, then maybe, but still, damn it. All right, no perfect for me. I got really lucky though that Christy was able to accept my outfit though. I gave Christy the wrong outfit. I gave Christy the outfit that I was going to give Hitomi, and I gave Hitomi the outfit that I was going to give to Christy. Although I have to admit, she does look good in the white. Matches her hair. Very nice. Very nice. Although no more games. I have to win this. And booyah, won it. Awesome. As soon as they go up there, I know I won. So look at that. I have 787,300 Zach dollars. I am about a little over $200,000 left before I could even attempt to buy the Venus, which again just shows you just how crazy it is. Before we end this day, I do want to get Christy something because we have to give her something. So I'm looking at on here. You can give her accessories. Accessories don't they do butter her up, just not as much as the items that you can get from the Zach store, from the Zachaball shops. Now, one thing that I know for sure Christy likes is black. She likes the color black for some reason, so I know she'll like this. So let's give her that, just to have something to give. And I don't think I have anything else in my inventory. So let's try to get something else here. And I want to get Hitomi something too. Let's see, what can I give Hitomi? I'm trying to wonder if Christy likes this outfit. Okay, so it says here that she dislikes the indigo, but the skirt. This is the skirt. So Christy wouldn't like this outfit, which is good for me because it's hella expensive. But it doesn't say anything about... Yeah, so let me go ahead and get this for Christy. I have to remember, that one's for Christy, not Hitomi. And then I can maybe get... This one already has... Alright, let's see if I can get this one for Hitomi. There it is. And yeah, let's play one more game here, and then we can call it a day, and then we can call it a part. Alright. Man, this part's gonna be... I think this might be the longest part so far. It's going into 30 hours. Or 30 hours. 30 minutes. Jesus. Alright, here we go. Last match of the game. Or last match of the day. Last match of the part. So let's make this one count. One thing that I can say about the did we get it? Yeah. Okay, good. One thing that I can say, and this is just a stretch... But I think one of the reasons also why it might be a good idea to keep your girls light, and I'm not trying to be racist or anything like that, but it's in this stage in particular, and especially when it becomes like afternoon when the sun goes down, you guys may have noticed that when the sun goes down, it's very hard to see certain... Like, it starts to get difficult to see the girls and the volleyball itself. So that may be one of the reasons why you have the option of changing the skin tone of your girl. So right now, you know, somebody like Lisa is kind of difficult. Like, she kind of blends a little bit to the grass because it's dark. Whereas somebody like Kasumi, who is probably the lightest girl in here, it's fairly easy to follow where she's going. The same way... Aw, damn it. Oh, come on. Yes. Oh, that was close. The same way that... That was harsh. Jesus. Good God. I love that. I'm sorry, Hitomi, but that was funny. So it plays the same way as I mentioned before. It's sort of like the same dynamic with the volleyball, where you can change the color of the volleyball by buying different colored volleyballs at the accessory shop. It's the same thing. This volleyball, at least right now, it stands out because it's light compared to the background, you know, the dark green. Whereas the silver volleyball, which is the other colored volleyball that I have, it would blend right in. So it would be a lot harder to see it. Booyah, it's mine. Awesome. Come on, baby, two more. And booyah. And come on, here we go. Oh, damn. I also mentioned before that there's some outfits here that actually eventually showed up again in the proper Dead or Alive series. I know for a fact that one of the outfits, I can't remember if I have it with me or not. I might wear it. It's a white one piece. I think I have it. I can't remember if I have it in this file or not. I might have had it in the file when I was playing the during my live stream. But there are some outfits that eventually made it to the actual... Get off me! To the, like, the Dead or Alive, the fighting games, which I always thought was pretty cool. They serve no purpose other than fan service, but, you know, it's Dead or Alive, so of course it's going to have fan service. Alright, come on. Come on. One more. We got to call it a day. This video's running pretty long. Oh, damn it. Alright, here we go. And booyah! Come on, here we go. Nice. And there we go. We have broken 800,000 Zach dollars. I have no idea what I'm going to be spending it on, because we have to spend it on something, because this game's almost done. Alright, so let's go back to our hotel. Let's see if we actually got something this time from Hitomi and Christy. We got something from Zach, as always. And that's it. Damn it! Alright, so let's make a gift here. And we said that the indigo was going to go to Christy. And the whatever this is called is going to go to Hitomi. And no polished black. We'll just keep it for now. There are some items that eventually they spoil. Like some of the food items, you actually have a time limit as to when you can give it to certain girls. And this is DOA. Yeah, DOA 3 opening movie. Unfortunately, I'm not going to show that off. If you want to see the DOA 3 opening movie, you can go check out my Let's Play of it. Shameless plug-in. Over on my channel. But the other reason, as I mentioned before, in the last part, part 4 of DOA Xtreme Beach Volleyball got flagged from the WWE for no reason whatsoever. Go back to part 4, or part 5, rather. To hear my explanation of that. It's very weird. So, for that reason, I'm not going to show that. So, anyway, guys, that's it for part 6 of Let's Play Dead or Alive Xtreme Beach Volleyball. I will see you guys in part 7, and let's say goodnight to Kasumi. I was confused. Hitomi and Kasumi. Good night, Kasumi. Hope I have a nice dream tonight. And I will see you guys next time. As always, if you liked this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel if you want to get more stuff from me. In the meantime, if you like my videos, be sure to find me on Twitter, Tumblr, Raptr, and Screwattack.com to see the other gaming-related content that I upload. Info is in the description. Who knows? Maybe you'll like my stuff. Maybe?